Welcome to Comic Basics. Today's episode, M'Baku, the Man-Ape. But before we get to that, if after watching this video you liked what you saw, please hit that subscribe button. The creation of Roy Thomas and John Buscema, Man-Ape first appeared inside the pages of Avengers number 62 back in 1969. M'Baku was born in the fictional nation of Wakanda. From early on, he was considered one of the nation's best warriors. Being considered only one of the best warriors didn't sit too well with M'Baku. This was especially so because the nation's best warrior was the Black Panther. Due to this, he plotted to overthrow the Black Panther and return Wakanda to its naturally primitive state. He sought to return Wakanda to a primitive state because he felt that the over-reliance on technology hindered them as a nation and contradicted what they stood for. To return Wakanda, he set out to defeat T'Challa in a battle and take control of the throne. While the Black Panther was in America giving aid to the Avengers, M'Baku began to revive the White Gorilla cult. From there, he successfully stalked and killed the rare White Gorilla. With the gorilla dead, M'Baku ate its flesh, bathed in its blood, and was bestowed the power of the White Gorilla. Once T'Challa returned to Wakanda, M'Baku, now called Man-Ape, issued him a challenge in battle. If he were to win the battle, T'Challa would be forced to give up the throne and M'Baku would be named king. The battle between the two was fierce, and at its conclusion, Man-Ape did in fact leave victorious. Unfortunately, before he was done, he tied T'Challa to a totem and attempted to topple it on him. This would have worked had the totem actually not toppled, in a way burying him underneath. The thought dead Man-Ape was found and revived by one of his supporters. Man-Ape tracked the Black Panther to New York, where he became a member of the Lethal Legion, kidnapped his girlfriend, and threatened that the only way he could get her back is if he once again fought him in battle. He was able to defeat and take T'Challa captive, albeit through deceit and cheating. The Avengers came to his rescue, but unfortunately wound up being caught themselves. Eventually, Captain America breaks free of capture, beats Man-Ape in battle, and frees his teammates. Now free, T'Challa states that M'Baku is never allowed to step foot in Wakanda again. If he did, he would face death. Humiliated, M'Baku began to roam the earth as a mercenary for hire. As far as powers go, M'Bakus are pretty standard for villains. He possesses superhuman strength, superhuman agility, superhuman speed, superhuman stamina, and superhuman durability. He is also proficient in hand-to-hand combat. And I'm going to wrap it up here. I hope you enjoyed that, and if you did, please hit that subscribe button. Thanks, guys. Look, at the end of the day, I know there's a million YouTube channels out there, and for you to take a few of your precious minutes to watch one of my videos means the world to me. I hope you'll come back, and until then, I'll catch you next time.